that you found a way to let me down slowly. A little sympathy, I hope you can show me. If you wanna go, then I'll be so lonely. If you're leaving, baby, let me down slowly. Let me down, down, let me down, down, let me down, let me down, down, let me down, down, let me down.
I don't need my drugs, we could be lonely.
If you're leaving, baby, let me down slowly. Cold skin, drag my feet on the tile as I'm walking down the corridor. And I know we haven't talked in a while, so I'm looking for an open door. Don't cut me down, throw me out, leave me in a waste. I once was a man with dignity and grace. Now I'm slipping through the cracks of your cold embrace. So please, please, could you find a way to let me down slowly? A little sympathy, I hope you can show.
I promise that you'll never find another like me. I know that all my hair, fool, baby. You know I never think before I jump. And you're the kind of guy the ladies want. And there's a lot of cool chicks out there. I know that I would psycho on the phone. I never leave well enough alone. And troubles gonna fall away. because that my name is Lui Jing. I come from Intel. This session, we talk about how to use the OpenStack and the Omni-Path to manage HPC. So we can talk about the objective and talk about some the Omni-Path architecture. And we also talk about why we need to use the Omni-Path. And we talk about little about the Omni-Path detail, then we can how to enable the Omni-Path by OpenStack, how to manage the HPC by OpenStack. Then I will go the detail for the open the flow, the detail flow. Then I can show some demo. So Omni-Path is designed for HPC. We can look at the some Omni-Path switch, then can manage by Neutron. Currently, we use the Ionic to manage the bare metal. And we create virtual network for multi-tenant. For the infrastructure owner, when we it is easy to manage the HPC by OpenStack, we can create a different tenant, and we can assign the different port to different tenant. Then we can use the Ionic to deploy the OS. For the user, then we can get some security and the low latency network, and also we can get QoS per tenant. So it is easy to manage the HPC by the Omni-Path and the OpenStack. So we look at the OPA. OPA is designed by Intel. So this is the Intel has an end-to-end solution for HPC. We look at the lesson adapter, HPI adapter. It is similar with the Ethernet interface. Then it connects to edge switch. We connect the Ethernet adapter to TOR, right? Then Intel has a direct switch, it is like an aggregation switch. Then edge switch connect to direct switch. Then we have another software to manage. That's a fabric manager, like SDN, to manage all the switch and host interface. And we have the cable to connect adapter and switch. So Intel has a total solution for HPC. But this session we talk about how to we enhance the OpenStack, how to manage by OpenStack. So why we need to use Omni-Path? So Omni-Path has a better performance, and the performance price is good. We can show the performance data, there's some better performance. And price performance also is good. Intel has designed the OPA. It is very it is scaled from entry level to very large scale. It can be 10,000 or 100,000 node. there's some key difference. The Intel built this technology from the QLogic and Cray, and enhanced some fabric function and do some the HPC optimization. So when we look at the Omni-Path, we all there's some membership of virtual fabric. There's some managed by the central fabric manager. So there's some HFI and HFI connected to switch. Then we can compare this virtual fabric is a layer two network. It is similar with we create a network tenant. It's a layer two tenant, and it is very similar to VLAN. This P key is very similar to VLAN. P key is a 16-bit ID. It is very similar with VLAN. Same P key. It is means all the node is the same virtual fabric. So different virtual fabric, it means if your node is in different virtual fabric, it cannot connect. So you need to assign the P key to different port and then assign the port to different virtual fabric. But we want to automate it. We want to use API to manage this the virtual fabric. So we leverage OpenStack. We develop some component in the OpenStack to manage this the virtual fabric. So we can see this GUID is like a MAC address. It is similar with MAC address. It total 64-bit. The 24-bit for vendor ID and the 40-bit for port ID. So we will talk about later how to use the GUID to manage the GUID. So we also talk about some manager, fabric manager. It is like a SDN. It is control the fabric manager, manage the all the switch. So you can send a command to fabric manager. Say, I need to create a virtual fabric. I need to add one port to virtual fabric. It is like I need to create a network. I need to create a port. I need to combine this port to binding some port. So this is the virtual fabric manager. So normally, if you have no OpenStack, it means you need to write some script to call that script to call virtual manager. So we can look at this picture. So we use the Ionic for bare metal to manage the bare metal. Then we use the Neutron to manage network. It means we manage the virtual fabric. We manage port. Then we in the Neutron, we call, when we create a network, we allocate a virtual fabric. We create a port, we can assign that port to virtual fabric. We can call virtual manager. Then virtual manager can manage all the switch and port. When we look at this, we can create a different tenant. Same P key, it means same tenant. It is same the virtual fabric. So we create two tenant. Tenant one include two nodes. And tenant to create for node. All this same tenant as same P key. So we can look at how to implement in the OpenStack. Currently, we use the Neutron to manage the virtual fabric. And there's some software run on the fabric manager. Then Neutron will call fabric manager. Then fabric manager can configure all the switch and host HFI. So currently, Neutron has no knowledge about the OPA fabric. We develop a new component, networking Omni-Path project, and we integrate Neutron and Ionic to provision in the bare metal. So we can see here. So lesson two interface. The left side is Omni-Path interface, and the right side is provisioning by Ethernet. So we can use the Ethernet to do some control paths, like IPMI, how to boot PSE. So right side is PSE and IPMI. The left side is how to configure the fabric port, how to assign the P key to the Omni-Path port, and how to create a new virtual fabric. So this is the left side. So I will talk about networking Omni-Path ML2 driver. Currently, we write a new new mechanism driver, ML2 mechanism driver, the networking Omni-Path. We reuse the type driver. We use the VLAN type driver. We mapping VLAN to P key. We just reuse the P key because currently the P key use the 16 bit. We leverage VLAN. So in this Omni-Path mechanism driver, they will look at how to create a port, how to bind in the port. When we bind in the port, we run the SSH to fabric manager, then run all the command how to bind in the port. We use the GUID. Currently, we 64 GUID. We mapping the GUID to MAC address. So we can look at this in detail. So when we binding the less binding VIP is we use the currently we use a VIF type is P key. Then we add some actual DHCP option to we add some GUID here. Then we allocate a MAC address from the GUID. So user can assign the IP address. And GUID, we reuse the MAC address from the GUID. So we can get the MAC address and mapping the MAC address, and user can allocate IP address. So user can provisioning bare metal with the IP and create virtual fabric and assign the P key to port. So this is a configuration for mechanism driver. It's not complicated. So let's say SSH user and SSH key. This is the IP address is a fabric manager node. So mechanism driver can use this information to log into fabric manager and call the how to create a port, how to assign the port. So we look at this is a neutron port. Less than different. We can look at the sub ID is the same. We just we have a MAC address. We just the less than different. Just the VIF type is a P key. So others are same. So we can look at the flow, how to binding the. This is a typical neutron port binding. So we create a server, then schedule VM in the host. Then we create the port and binding the port. When we deploy the VM, then we binding the port. But this is a typical neutron port binding. When we look at the Omni-Path, so there's a different here. Then we request the port binding. We ask the manager to configure the port in the virtual fabric. So we already have some VIF type is a P key. So we call this command in the virtual fabric manager to manage all the virtual fabric and the port. So there's some demo. We demo how to use Ionic and Neutron to how to provisioning the bare metal in Omni-Path. So we list the node. This original node. So we want to create another node here. So we can show the list. We want to provision in CentOS or Ubuntu in bare metal. So we want to use the kernel image. So we can specify the runfs. So we want to deploy new in the OPA 0. So this is we want to enroll the new information for in the Ionic. We specify the IPMI address and the driver and some kernel image and the RAM disk. So before I show the slides, there's some the right side is for the IPMI PSE boot. Left side is the how to provisioning the port, virtual port. So we already we want to specify the kernel, the OS. This is for the for provisioning network. It is for the IPMI DHCP. So we want to enroll the all the information to IPMI. So we currently not a provisioning. So we can list node here. So when we already logging the mechanic when we create the server, the Neutron call the networking Omni-Path, then Omni-Path can create some configuration in the virtual fabric manager. Then we use the OpenStack create server command line to create a new server. We can then we create a server here. You can see we have two network, right? The first one network is Omni-Path network, Omni-Path port, and the second one is provisioning. We use Ethernet for provisioning, and Omni-Path we can configure the Omni-Path port virtual fabric. Then we can see, we can show port. You can see this is a GUID, right? Then we can show the OpenStack port. Only different is the VIF type is a P key. So we have GUID here in the virtual fabric. So we have more information here. So the first one is Omni-Path architecture. So all the source code we already open source to this Git networking Omni-Path. And we need to install Omni-Path in the kernel. So let's learn how to install some the Omni-Path kernel. The driver. So, any question? Yes.
Thanks. That's really interesting. Can you prevent a tenant instance from becoming the fabric manager?
So, your question is how to prevent. So fabric manager is another control site.
Yeah, but can that be anywhere in the network, or is it?
Can be any. I can. So again, you can see here, the fabric manager is in another node. So you can, you just, in the Neutron side, we have new component, Omni-Path. Networking Omni-Path is a mechanism driver in the Neutron. So networking Omni-Path just call SSH to fabric manager. Then fabric manager can manage all the switch and host port. So it is separate. No more question? So, any question? So, I think we are done here.